for a lot of people, as when the weather gets colder, they actually lose more money. And there seems to be a correlation between the temperatures dropping and our wallets getting slimmer. And joining us live to tell us more about that is Dean Benton of Benton Green Energy. Thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome, Myra. Yes. Thank you.
Now, what causes us to lose money when it gets colder?
Well, it's two things. Mainly, as the days get shorter, we use more lighting. That's a big part of the expense. And then, of course, the vast majority of it is the cost to heat our homes, because there's just more of a temperature difference between the outdoors and the inside of your house than there is even in the summer. It could be 30 degrees out, and you want to keep your house about 68, so that's almost 40 degrees difference. So it's just more expensive to heat the house than it is to cool it.
And one of the things you focus on is air sealing, right? Because it's you've described it as putting a cap on your house to keep all that air you're paying to keep cool or warm.
Great
inside,
analogy,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that's a great point. You know, heat, as everyone knows, heat rises. So if you put a cap on the house, it's just like putting a blanket on yourself. It just keeps the heat inside the house, and you spend less to heat air that's seeping into your house as a result of air leakage, which is what we test for.
Now, we have some photographs of some problem areas to look
at.
Okay,
right.
What is this? This is an unheated water heater, is that right?
That's exactly what it is, and we find that very often. That's one of the things people can do for themselves. You can go to Home Depot, Lowe's, True Value, something, and they're like $30 for a blanket that'll fit pretty much any standing water heater like that.
And that'll save you money in the long run, because it takes less time or effort for that thing to heat
mm-hmm.
up the water. Is that
exactly.
right?
Exactly. It's about $100 a year in most cases.
Great. Now, we have another next picture showing some detached insulation. What's wrong with that?
We see that all the time, where you'll have they may have had a water leak, or they've had condensation has gotten up in the insulation and it's fallen down. But the main thing is, if it's not touching the floor, you just have a bare floor subjected to either very warm temperatures or very cold temperatures. And what can happen there is, if it's moist air in the summer and it touches that cold floor that you're air conditioning is causing to be cold, it's much like iced tea glass. It'll just cause moisture, and you can have some mold issues.
Now, we have another picture here. It's a gaping hole in a duct system. That's a big problem.
We see this all the time, and you can just imagine, if you're paying the heat and cool your house, you want the air to go inside the house rather than down in the crawl space or up in the attic. And we see that, and that's literally, that happens all the time. We see it, so that's something else we fix.
Doesn't cost that much to fix that, right?
No, it's very inexpensive to fix that, and it saves a lot of money. That and air sealing tend to be the biggest savers of anything you can do.
Now, final picture here, it's an open attic. Most of the time we don't really pay attention when we're going up and down those stairs, but what happens here?
Well, most of the time where we go out, we'll see people will have an attic access in their hallway or something like that, just like this one. Well, when we get to looking at it and we run our tests, you'll just feel the air just blowing out around that opening, and it needs to be sealed off and insulated.
So you've started this business, which focuses on helping people become more energy efficient.
That's
and aware
right.
of what happens. Tell us a little bit more about Benton Green Energy.
Well, what we do, we originally intended to just help people find out where's the biggest energy loss. We look at a house, every aspect of energy usage in a house, and then come up with guidelines for these people to know what money they can spend that'll pay back quickest. In other words, where the low-hanging fruit is in the house.
Great.
So that's what we do. Use a lot of expensive equipment that I'll be paying on a long time.
Yeah.
But it yields great results.
Well, we will catch up with you a little later in the newscast about some of those other things that you
great.
Do with this family-run business.
All right.
Thank you so much,
Thank
and we'll
you.
See you in a little bit.
Okay, sounds good.